G'day folks, Peter Young for Fishing Monthly Magazines, and I'm with Andrew Stephen from Melbourne Marine Centre, and we're in beautiful Gippsland in Victoria. And Andrew, what's going on? We don't normally have boat weather like this for our boat tests. What's happening?
No, we're very lucky today. Blue skies, nice sunny day. It's great.
Well and truly. So take us through what boat we are testing today.
So today we've got the Bulls Bay 1700 centre console, which is a boat out of the US. It's designed largely towards the angler, so for casting lures, be it hard bodies or soft plastics, things like that. Nice stable platform, nice keel entry as well, so it is quiet through the water when you are travelling along from one spot to another.
It's all about stealth and being able to cast and use it to get to where the fish are, really, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly right.
So take us through what some of the key features of the boat are.
Yeah, so this boat's got dual live wells in the back, right tucked up in the corner of the boat as well. Plenty of storage across the transom area too, so you can hide bits and pieces away, your tackle boxes and things like that. Forward of the boat, there's also additional storage. Nice large centre console as well, so, you know, good room to mount your electronics. A very functional key switch assembly area as well for your navigation lights and things like that too. So a very user-friendly boat.
Yeah, it's the sort of boat that I guess any angler could pretty much use and be comfortable getting out on the water. So as far as we touched briefly on the electronics, just take us through some of the electronics you've actually got on the boat we're testing.
Yeah, so in this particular one, in the centre console there, we've got the Garmin Striker 7. It's one of the new Plus Series units that's just been released on the market this month, which gives you the side view and the clear view, as well as your traditional sonar as well. Then flush mounted in the dash, we've got the Garmin 557 XS, just for your mapping. And then you've got your motor guide up the front, your 12-volt, 54-pound. GPS model as well.
And that's giving us the ability to go and catch the fish that we couldn't catch.
Yeah, try and sneak up on them anyway.
Well and truly. So we've also got the Mercury four-stroke on the back. Just take us through what that is, and is that the maximum horsepower for this boat?
So this is the 90 command thrust four-stroke Mercury, the new 2.1 litre range of engines. It's not the maximum horsepower. This boat's rated to 115 horsepower, but the 90, you know, provides plenty of performance. Great fuel return as well with the command thrust gearbox, being that it's got that big, large diameter propeller. So.
Yeah, certainly gives you a good hole shot as well, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
The other thing people want to know, I mean, it's not a huge boat, but it's not small either. As far as towing it, type of vehicle, launching, retrieving?
So we've packaged this up on a McKay multi-roller trailer. It's a single axle trailer. Towing wise, you're probably going to look at around somewhere in the 1200 kilo mark as a towing package when it's loaded. In terms of getting on and off the trailer, being a multi-roller, very easy to launch and retrieve, and again, you know, easy to step onto the deck of the boat from the bow of the trailer as well and climb up there.
Fantastic. So I was talking about value for money earlier. Price point of this boat as we see it today?
As we see it today, with everything that's on it, you're $47,000, and that's rego safety gear out in the water fishing. We can build them obviously a little bit cheaper than that if someone has a budget in mind, and we'll, you know, into the low to mid 30s if really need be. So even with a 75 four stroke on the back, being it's the same motor as the 90. So
fantastic. So, and if people want to contact you or find out more information about the boat, what's the best way to do that?
Yeah, so the Bulls Bay information's on our website at melbournemarine.com.au. Or if they'd like to call us and talk to either myself or Jamie, give me a call on 9703 2003.
There you go. So as far as this boat goes, again, we'd like to take you out in the water and show you what it's all about. So yeah, Victoria certainly has turned the weather on for us today. Absolutely perfect day, lots of blue sky, not a lot of wind, and the perfect day to test out the Bulls Bay 1700. There's a few ways to sum this boat up, but certainly one of them, and the most appropriate one, is that it is angler-friendly. Lots of casting space, plenty of storage, the correct electronics, so the Garmin sounder, the motor guide on the front of it, all make it very user-friendly when it comes to casting. stability on the water at rest as well as underway is fantastic, and certainly it rides beautifully. I mean, the beauty of a fiberglass hull is there is no doubt that when you're out there, it's that beautiful quietness. The entire time you're on the water, half the time you didn't even know the motor was going. Andrew was saying to us when he saw the performance figures of the Mercury 90 horsepower with the CT gearbox that he wanted to play around with the prop a little bit more, but I was still very, very impressed with how the Mercury performed. When you consider that this boat has a 115 horsepower maximum rating, I was expecting the 90 to be a bit sluggish, but that certainly wasn't the case. It was actually fantastic and a lot of fun to drive around. I would call it a pocket rocket. 57 kilometres an hour was the maximum speed we achieved, with the best economy around that 3,500 to 4,000 revs. I have to say, this is my type of boat. You know, if I was going to be doing this type of fishing, which is, you know, casting to edges, picking out pockets, roaming around on the electric motor, this is the type of fiberglass boat that I would love to own. Very, very nice indeed. If you want to know more about the Bulls Bay and the other range of boats that Andrew has at Melbourne Marine Centre, you can jump onto their website, melbournemarine.com.au, and all the contact details for Andrew's there. So I think it's time we might have to put this boat back on the water, take advantage of this beautiful weather that Victoria's put on for us today, and go out and do a little bit more fishing. So until next time, we'll see you out in the water.